How's it going, friends? Welcome back to Top 10 Tier List. I'm your host, Jared Bronstein, and today I'll be ranking the top 10 worst movies of 2019. If this is your first time here, this isn't necessarily a factual list. Instead, I've just chosen 10 movies that have been released in 2019, and I'll be ranking them. So make sure you guys are subscribed, click that bell, and of course, drop a comment down below with other lists you guys want to see ranked on here.
Welcome to Tier List. This is where we rank anything and everything into tiers. S stands for Superior God Mode. A, Absolute Dominance. B for Basic. C, Who Cares? D for Trash. F, Get the f*** out of here.
Now, I'll be honest, there are probably some of the best movies to come out in 2019 on this list, which is why it's going to be so hard to rank them, but only one way to find out, and let me forewarn you guys, people are going to get triggered. So here goes. We got Avengers Endgame, Us, Shazam, Gemini Man, The Lion King, Joker, Once Upon a Time in Hollywood, It Chapter 2, Hustlers, and Rocket Man. Alright, so obviously S tier is like hands down the worst movie to come out in 2019, F is the best on this list. Little rule here is I'm only going to put two per letter, I guess you could say. Because I'm not going to put a bunch of S or a bunch of F, like I want to make it fun and hard for me to do. So we're going to start off Gemini Man. I'm a huge fan of Will Smith, I love the guy. The movie itself didn't really do it for me, unfortunately. I don't know, even when I saw the trailer, I remember like a year ago or 6 months ago, however long, I was like, that's kind of a dumb idea. It, like a good premise, but not the best idea. I don't know, I mean, obviously I could change it, because it's my list. I don't want to put an S, it's pretty bad though. Yeah, we'll start at S with Gemini Man. I love Will Smith, don't get me wrong, I love Will Smith, but Bad Boys. Bad Boys 3, that is gonna be the best movie, but Gemini Man just really didn't do it for me, so that's getting an S tier. Sorry. It Chapter 2. Yeah, scary. I think I liked the first chapter a bit better. Would I say it was one of the worst movies of the year? Probably not, but on this list, maybe. No, I wouldn't say that bad. I'm gonna give It Chapter 2 a B for now. It might, subject to change, gonna go B for now based off of the fact that it wasn't as good as the first one. I don't know, it just didn't do it, didn't do it for me. The first one was good, it was scary. Second one, yeah, there was a little bit of scary scenes, but like it wasn't the same. It didn't have that same, I don't know if it's sinister or what the right word is, it wasn't the same for me, so I'll go B for now. Again, like I said, people are gonna get triggered. We're only 2 out of 10 movies in, guys, so buckle up, stay for the ride. Hustlers. Ugh. So we got a movie here that's full of some female actors and then just some musicians that have a name that are thrown into a movie like Cardi B and Lizzo. Are they actors? I don't think so. They make music. So why are they in this movie? No, because they're a name. Probably a lot of hate for that, but it is what it is. Am I wrong? Definitely not. You could have had a handful of other actors in this film that would have made it so much better, but you just threw in Cardi B and Lizzo. Why? Because their names are always on the radio. And, you know, again, maybe not my type of movie to watch, so maybe that's why I didn't enjoy it as much. I don't know. It just didn't really do the trick for me. Although J-Lo, I like her a lot. But, and the girl from Riverdale, Lily Reinhart, is that her name? Yeah. Lily, you're great. But definitely, I don't know, better than Gemini Man. This might go S as well. I might even drop Gemini Man down to an A. Again, some like comedic scenes and stuff, you know, like that haha comedy, but not this is funny. It's just like, so I'm gonna actually give Hustlers an S and drop Gemini down to an A for now. Avengers Endgame. So I'm not gonna say it was bad. It was good. I will say it was good. A little long though. I will admit there were some parts where I was kind of like, okay, 2.5 hours. Okay, got like 1 hour 45 left. It was good. I liked it. Again, comedic scenes. I've always liked superhero movies. That being said, again, maybe not my type of movie. There's a movie on here I already know is gonna go to F because I liked it a lot. But I would still give Avengers Endgame, like, again, overall, there's tons of jokes, a lot of upbeat, like, fun, you know, oh, like, action. It was good. I'm gonna say D for Avengers Endgame, not F. The best of the worst? I'll go D for now. For now, we'll go D. Again, I can only put 2 movies per letter, so I gotta be very smart about this. Of course, I could change it when all said and done. But for now, we're gonna go with this here. Joker. See, this was a good movie. A few filler scenes that I was like, was that really necessary? I think they kind of just pushed it to hit that 2-hour mark, which is fine. But I thought his performance was incredible, and I just, the movie overall, the cinematography was great. The storyline was pretty crazy. There were even some like unexpected, almost scary moments in it that I liked a lot. Not gonna ruin it. They could have changed the ending a little bit and made someone at the end kind of tie into the story with the Joker. But overall, again, I liked it a lot. I'm gonna give this film an F, meaning it was the best of the movies on this list. Of course, I don't think all these movies were necessarily the worst of the year. This is just to make it harder for me. I could have just chosen a bunch of shit movies and been like, oh, they're all shit. But that's not very fun. Who wants to watch that? Shazam. This movie got a lot of mixed reviews. Again, comedic, but I don't even think I knew the superhero Shazam before I saw the film, so I didn't really have a place like, oh wow, that's Shazam. Like Endgame, you know, I grew up with Iron Man. I didn't really grow up with Thor, but I grew up with Iron Man, grew up with Spider-Man, grew up with Wolverine. I'm joking, I know that's X-Men, it's a joke. Like Captain America, I grew up with those guys, so I was excited. Shazam, I was like, oh, who's this new superhero? I didn't realize he was like an older, so I'm gonna give Shazam a B. Again, comedic, some fun little scenes, but like overall, film itself didn't do it for me. Like Endgame was very good, Shazam was like, it's okay. Would I see it again? Definitely not. Would I see Endgame again? Yeah. I wouldn't pay, but I would see it again if someone paid for me. Us. So this was the follow-up from Jordan Peele when he made Get Out. I thought Get Out was very well done. It was scary. The music, it was great. I saw Us expecting something very similar. Not even similar in the sense of like movies, but similar in the sense of like being scared and being on the edge of my seat and like the twists and the turns. And it did have a cool twist, but definitely not the best follow-up for Get Out. It was definitely better than It, horror-wise, better than Shazam. I'm gonna say for now, I'm gonna give it a C. It was good, it was scary, there was a great twist at the end, but not as scary as I wanted it to be or thought it would be. So Us is getting C. Rocket Man. So, I don't know if you guys saw this movie, it's about Elton John. It was like almost like a musical, like biography about his life, kinda. Great film, I liked it a lot. I thought Taron Egerton, I think that's how you say his name. He was great. He plays Eggsy in Kingsman, and I saw him in this, and I didn't even know it was the same person. That's how good he was. I'm not gonna lie, I'm actually going to see Elton John tonight. By the time you guys see this, it might be like a week ahead. But regardless, very excited. Elton John's one of my favorite musicians. Unpopular opinion, this movie was better than Bohemian Rhapsody. There you go, I said it. This is getting an F. Right next to The Joker. Not saying that they're equivalent films, but like, I would see Rocket Man again before I would see Endgame. Again, this is my personal opinion. You guys can't tell me I'm wrong, because this is what I believe. The Lion King. If you guys don't know, The Lion King is one of my favorite Disney movies of all time. Like, when Mufasa died, bro, that shit tore me up. The live action did not do it for me. I was very disappointed. I was excited when I first heard about it. I'm like, it's gonna be great. And then, much like Hustlers, they're like, Beyonce's in it. And I'm like, Beyonce, is she a voice actor? She's a singer. She's got a great voice, don't get me wrong. She's not a voice actor. Why is she in this film? James Earl Jones is in it. That was great. But, I mean, like, why? Why would you do this? I don't know, just kind of triggered me. Obviously, I like the storyline, but again, given the history of The Lion King and how good of a film it was, I feel like the live action really did not do it any justice at all. I'm not gonna say it was the worst movie, but this easily goes next to Gemini Man with an A, no problem. Once Upon a Time in Hollywood. This movie got a lot of hype. I was so excited. I love Tarantino films. I thought the acting was pretty solid. I don't know why Margot Robbie was really pushed to be in the film, like in the sense of like, she was like a star of it. She was barely in it. It was mostly Leo and Brad, which again, they were very good. The ending was great. Obviously, it wasn't a true story. So, Margot Robbie played Jared Tate. I'm not gonna ruin it, but again, I love Tarantino films. Reservoir Dogs, one of my favorites. Pulp Fiction's another classic. Once Upon a Time in Hollywood, it was good, don't get me wrong, but I don't think it was as good as people hyped it up to be. I would say this is either a C or a D. Definitely not an F. I'm leaving Rocket Man and Joker there because these two were easily two of my favorite movies in 2019. Again, I like Tarantino. I like the idea of a lot of his movies are kind of just like you're a fly on the wall in someone's life and then things happen and then it ends. There's no, at least, you know, for the most part in most of his films, it doesn't seem like there's like a real story arc. Like Pulp Fiction, I don't know if you guys have seen that, but there's a lot of scenes that are like, what's going on right now? And it's great, I love it. Once Upon a Time in Hollywood, I'll give it a D next to Avengers. I think it's equivalent there. So now, Avengers, Once Upon a Time in Hollywood, Joker, and Rocket Man, and these were all good movies of 2019. The rest are kind of like, they're okay. And that does it for the top 10 worst movies of 2019, ranked based on my opinion. I wanna know if you guys agree or disagree with me. I understand this was a tough one for us to do, but that's what makes it so fun, I guess. I don't know. Anyways, guys, that does it for this one. Make sure to subscribe, click that bell so you guys can stay up to date with all of our videos, and drop us some suggestions down below. I wanna know if you guys agree or disagree, like I said, with my ranking, and let me know which you guys say was the worst or the best movie based off of this list. I've been your host, Jared Bronstein, and we'll see you in the next one.